Hey guys, this is David Kwan here, and the topic here is yet again another next-gen trend, and I'm putting that in quotes because it is kind of a misnomer, because it's not like I'm saying, you know, this is the beginning point, this is the only time it's happening, and this is the only time it's starting. Now, this trend has actually been something that game makers have been trying so hard, so many times, for so long. And that is, of course, trying to put an MMO onto a console. And I finally actually think it's starting to happen, and I think it will actually be successful in the next generation. That is my prediction anyway, but it is something that game makers have been trying so hard for so long, because the benefits are there. An MMO, the draw of an MMO for a publisher, is that they can put out a game, a person will buy the game. You know, a typical game, you buy it once, and that's pretty much it. You get the game, and you can play it forever or how many times you want. That's it, right? But with an MMO, like World of Warcraft, you buy it once, and you gotta keep feeding money into it to be able to play the game, like $15 a month. And once you stop paying that, you no longer get to really enjoy it. You no longer get to play it. That's the fee that you need to pay in order to keep playing. Because the draw of the MMO for the gamer is the draw of a persistent universe. This experience keeps changing. Developers add more and more to this experience as time goes on. And you want to be along for the ride. That's the draw of the MMO. And the draw of the publishers, of course, are making so much money off of one property, off of one game, just by maintaining the servers and just by making the experience more and more nuanced as time goes along. So this is something that developers have been trying so hard to put on the console, because on the PC market it's been successful a lot of times, but the console market is definitely bigger. So there is, if you make a MMO successful on the console, you could make so much money. It just hasn't been successful. The only MMO, I think, I might be wrong on this, but the only one that is notable to me is Final Fantasy XI, which ran on Xbox 360 and the PS2, along with PC, of course. I can't really think of any other games that succeeded as an MMO on the console. All the other MMOs that tried to make it on the console ended up being free-to-play, or just didn't end up having a subscription-based model, or just faded out or faltered out. DC Universe Online, I think, is an example. Tried on the PS3, just kind of petered out. So, I think it's finally starting to happen. I think the key thing to look forward to is how well Destiny does. Because I do agree with Michael Pachter that I think, because it's Activision Blizzard, really. Activision is the publisher behind Destiny, even though the developer is Bungie. Activision is kind of the company that likes to do the subscription thing. So I think Destiny is somehow going to have some kind of subscription-based fee, and I think it might actually work, because that game looks amazing. I personally would probably not fork out the money and keep feeding money to experience Destiny. But I think Destiny will be that one shooter experience that is kind of the MMO on the console that might actually be super successful. I'm also looking forward to how Titanfall plays out. I'm not even sure if Titanfall counts as an MMO, would count as an MMO, but And then there's the Tom Clancy's The Division, which is like an RPG kind of thing, but it's also about this persistent universe and being connected online and interacting with other players online, so in a way, that could be considered an MMO. This line, of course, another one of those trends I mentioned about, talking about how single player and multiplayer, the line between distinguishing between the two is blurring and it's being destroyed. I think that's being especially true when we're starting to talk about online games and massive multiplayer online games. The line between those two are starting to be really blurred, and it's starting to happen on consoles. And I think this next generation is finally the console that's going to make it happen. Of course, Destiny is also on PS3, as all these other games are going to be on current gen platforms, but I think the success really is going to be moving forward. In the near future, in the distant future, what happens with MMOs on consoles? I predict that it's actually going to finally happen this time, and they're going to start being successful. That's my prediction. That's me being optimistic about the whole thing. I'm not even that into MMOs, but I think that might be happening. So we'll see how that goes on. I also predict that Dragon Age 3 is going to be kind of like more like an MMO than actual like a traditional RPG. And that might also be the case for The Witcher 3, although Witcher 3 seems to be a class all on its own. Anyway, what do you guys think about MMOs and consoles? Do you think it might finally actually happen this next generation of consoles, or do you think it will still fail as it always has done? Anyway, thanks for watching, and if you guys enjoyed, cheers.